So I'll tell you about my project. It's called Practical Stepwise Engineering of Correct Software. And my supervisors are Stefan Hallerstedt from the Electrical and Computer Engineering Department and Jakob van der Pol from the Computer Science Department. Yes, so I will preview introduce my project and then I'll try to explain some of the work I've been doing and some of the future works I plan to do. So basically, my project is about the verification of cyber-physical systems. I mean, it emanates from the hypothesis that formal proof technologies can be made more accessible to typical software engineers developing the cyber-physical systems that are controlling our everyday life. So basically, the need for this is that, I mean, cyber-physical systems are all around us and are essentially controlling so many things in our everyday life. So therefore, we need to make sure that the systems that we have dependable, like that we are building, are dependable. So basically, and if we want dependable software systems, then we want to be able to verify them in an easy manner that actually makes typical engineers use these methods. So, as I said, dependable software, cyber-physical systems means that we need to have some kind of good verification techniques. And since these systems span multiple domains, then we basically need to have multiple verification techniques that we can use. And I'm currently exploring two different kinds, versus simulation-based techniques, like in form of co-simulation, where we're basically talking about how we integrate the components. And I'm also looking at some proof-based techniques where we are looking about verifying like the individual components of the system. And you can also see here, I mean, if you want to do proof-based methods, you only can do it for like discrete systems. So now we just jump straight into co-simulation. So co-simulation is one of the simulation-based techniques. It lets you explore the behavior of a cyber-physical system. And the good thing is that it supports systems spanning multiple domains. So you can essentially, when you develop a system, you can use multiple tools to develop the different parts of the system, and then you can sort of combine them to get the complete simulation of the complete system. And it's a fully automated process using some of the tools developed here at Aarhus University in TPS and MISO2. But there are like some lack about the formal guarantees about the correctness of the simulation. And that is one of the things I'm sort of targeting in my project. So what you're really doing when you're running these kinds of simulation is that you are developing the different parts of the system. We call them the simulation units, and then you basically cobble them together to sort of get the complete simulation of the system. And essentially, like how it works in the real world is that you have a simulation unit and you cobble them with an orchestrator that dictates how each of the like components in the system should behave during simulation. And then you take each of the behavior traces of the individual component, and then you combine them, and that's the co-simulation. So the orchestrator is in fact an algorithm, like describing how the simulation units should act. So like how are data exchanged between the simulation units, and when and how do you calculate like future states? So I've just shown you here a like simple example where you have a scenario on the right, and then on the left you have the algorithm. So essentially you can just see, okay, the algorithm like dictates now you should calculate a new state. Now I want to get that output value and set it here. So, but you could ask yourself why you should care about these algorithms. So essentially, I have just a motivational example here of an example where you can see the green line here. That's sort of like the correct solution to the system that you're simulating. And you can say, if you pay respect or if you really care about your algorithm, you can get a simulation that is very close to the correct result. But if you don't really care about your orchestration algorithm, you can end up with something that is far off. And of course, you want to be able to have a good simulation. So you should really care about this algorithm. And you could ask yourself, okay, why should you have a systematic approach for this? It's like since simulation can really run for weeks. So if you just try different alternatives in the orchestration algorithms, then it could take ages for you to find a good one. So, and also because like the people that are doing these simulations, it can be very hard for them to conclude that it's actually been a frustration algorithm that is the reason why they're getting a bad simulation result. So the conclusion is that we need to come up with a way where we can like verify the orchestration algorithms and actually also synthesize these. So, and here the scenario verifier tool comes in. It's a tool that I've been working on. So it basically lets a co-simulation fractioner provides us with a scenario, then we can sort of like synthesize a good orchestration algorithm. Then we can also verify it. And like Flora and Kathy, they're currently trying to integrate it into Maestro 2. So a co-simulation fractioner essentially can come with a scenario and run a co-simulation using a verified algorithm. So I'll just briefly provide some insight to how we do this. So the verification, we do it in a model checker called UPAL, where we sort of run a symbolic version of the co-simulation using timed automators that are sort of mimicking a symbolic version of the co-simulation. So here we have like the simulation unit. So in the way that we sort of like do the verification of the algorithm is that we have some guarded transitions in the timed automator, and we have some invariant functions of the states. So that basically allows us to catch like mistakes in the orchestration algorithm and highlight them to the user. But we also have a method for like synthesizing these algorithms, and it's a graph-based approach where we just calculate the actions that we need to have in the algorithm, and then we denote this as the vertices. And when we have a notion of when an action is meaningful to do, so, and we call this the preconditions, and then we sort of like have the preconditions as the edges in the graph, and then we basically just use the topological ordering to get this orchestration algorithm. And then we have some heuristics or techniques that we can use to like extract algorithms of like a cyclic graph. So this is just the overall of the scenario verifier project. So it's a freely available tool that supports verification and synthesizing of the orchestration algorithm. So currently it's being integrated into Maestro 2. It'll be a part of a tutorial session at the formal methods conference this year. And as you can see, there are some international collaboratives. So the future here, we'll just try to use a tool called Mode that is like rewriting logic. Yes, let's jump to the proof-based methods. So the proof-based methods is like where you're using formal tools like theorem provers and model checkers. They're essentially quite mature tools, and they support like verification of very complex theorems. You can carry out very complex proofs in these tools, and they give you like a high, a very strong certainty about correctness. However, they are quite hard to master these tools, and it takes years to be able to master them. So meaning like a typical engineer would not use such tools normally. So we need to do something to make them like more accessible to the typical engineer. So you could either like lower the investment that the users need to do to use these tools using more automation, or we could sort of like increase the return of the investment by basically adding more value to the use of these tools. So the thing that we're working on is sort of like we want to prove things using sort of like a transition system. So imagine a software engineer writes a program, when we basically do some transformations and end up with a transition system of that, and that allows us to basically support multiple types or verification techniques here, like theorem proving and model checking. And then we basically, we could either prove the thing and say, yeah, it works, or we could send some information back to the user saying, hey, we cannot prove it, you need to provide us with some more information, or you need to fix the algorithm. Here's maybe an idea how to do it. So in order to do this, we need to go from a program to a transition system. Here I have two versions of the program, P and Q. They are essentially just calculating the absolute value of a number, and essentially they are both similar, the two programs, P and Q. But you can see here, we have like the most natural version of the program here, P, where you use like sort of like local variables. But whenever, so I would claim that P in the eyes of a program is the most natural version. But when you're looking at the transition system, then we have some like existential quantifiers over on the right from sort of like the most natural program. And it makes it very hard to extend this. And therefore, whenever we want to prove something from a transition system, we want the easiest possible. So what we want to do is that's sort of like the ideal situation. We want to be able to write programs in the form of P, but use the simplest transition system to sort of show stuff about it. So basically, we have come up with a theory for actually being able to like show that these two programs are equivalent, so we can transfer a program in the shape of P into something in the shape of Q. And then essentially, we can prove stuff about Q. And since the two are equivalent, then everything that we can show for Q, we can also show for P. So that's sort of the idea. So whenever we are transforming a program, we can basically do it in two different ways. So there's two different kinds of transformation strategy. So one is called lane sharing, where we basically try to reuse global variables as much as we can. It's not always possible to do this technique. So here you can see like S is using the lane sharing technique, but we also have the lane shifting technique, where we said just for each local variable, create like a global variable. And you can always do that. And we plan to explore these techniques more in the future in the context of model checking. And so when we should talk about continuing the journey in this direction, when we have done some transformations already, we want to create the transition system, and then we essentially want to explore the verification box and also explore how we could send useful information about the program from the verification back to the user, so the user essentially can like use that to correct the program but also guide the theory prover. Yes, that was all I had to say. I'll just leave you with some concluding remarks. So we saw about how simulation-based techniques and proof-based techniques can sort of assist each other in the development of the cyber-physical systems. And we looked a little bit about verification and synthesizing of orchestration algorithms in the scope of the scenario verifier. When you saw like some equivalence transformation of these variable scopes. Thanks.